Let's talk about the speed with which we are watching this market deteriorate.
We ran down at the same time.
Workers at home say a lot of their customers are freaked out.
Everything and more has been completely wiped out.
I want a two. A skilly diddly doo.
Picking stocks at about 6:35 a.m. PST. We're so lovely. It's so lovely to beat the S&P. It's so lovely to fight the SEC. It's so lovely. No, I'm not lonely. Look at all these friends around me. So I'll keep picking stocks so they love me. Oh, I love picking stocks at about 6:35 a.m. PST. But I'm not greedy, I'm not greedy, I'm just a simple man. I'm not greedy, it's all part of the plan. I'm not greedy, I need the money, 'cause maybe then she'll say she loves me. So I'll keep picking stocks till she loves me. Until she loves me, until she loves me. I wasn't 30 under 30, now these stocks are all I got. Until she loves me, until she loves me. I'm gonna work on being that rich, not poor dad. Book a reservation at the top of the Nomad. Maybe one day I'll be on one knee and have the money in the bank. So she says, yes, please. I love picking stocks at about 6:35 a.m. PST. It makes me happy. It makes me happy to beat the S&P. It makes me happy to fight the SEC. It makes me happy. No, I'm not lonely. Maybe just a little empty. So I'll keep picking stocks till I love me. I'll keep picking stocks till I love me. I'll keep picking stocks till I love me.
And then sour cream, cheese, and guacamole. Thank you.
5, 6, 7, 8. I got this brand new apartment in the south of Manhattan. It's this cool, quiet place right by Gramercy Tap. And I'm not poor anymore, I'm just chilling like the other guys. I'm not poor anymore, I'm just chilling like the other guys. I make these super inflated actuarial tables, making hand over fist from the ones I finagle. I'm not poor anymore, I'm just chilling like the other guys. I'm not poor anymore, I'm just chilling like the other guys. There ain't nothing left that I gotta prove. To the Soho house again. Oh, glad hand these Hollywood tights just to sell my songs for a little fame. I am free. I am free to relax in a woman's arms, feel her fingers through my hair. They say money can't buy happiness. Bullshit. Eating guacamole at Chipotle, soaking in my long hair with some orbe. I'm not poor anymore, I'm just chilling like the other guys. I'm not poor anymore, I'm just chilling like the other guys. Thank you. rock star, but I'm paying the bills, sipping by the reservoir in the Hollywood Hills. I'm not poor anymore, poor anymore. I'm not poor anymore, poor, poor anymore. I'm not poor anymore. I'm just chilling like the other guys. Finally.
My problem isn't with people making money. I get it. I just don't like these LBO dorks, the leverage buyout people, because they have no value for creating a viable business that has a good product.
Really?
They don't even care about the success of it.
That's
it,
not true.
It's type.
That's not true.
I'm actually with you in some of these cases.
Yeah, these type A, like, high achieving HBS McKinsey.
The bigger well,
doors that just see everything as a P&L sheet.
Right.
Right?
And if you're going to look at something
Microsoft
and figure
Excel,
out if
and
you
they're
could,
not trying to
and
add
using
real value.
Leverage in itself is an issue. Using leverage is what ends up blowing up markets.
I got a Michelin star dinner reservation on Mars where they got space-time caviar, and the gravity feels light, so we're floating all day and floating all night, so can you please just hurry it up, cause your EBITDA is shit and your product fit just sucks, there's no way I'm doing a deal, your private equity ain't good for me. Your crappy IP ASAP. Don't care about your identity. It's all about these valuations. Valuations on speculation. See, I'm just a working class man. I work to keep my class above the working man. So don't sell me on your ESG. Your private equity ain't good for me. Say you doubled up two times, and you've drawn down three times? You say you've done four LBOs in a row? I don't think so. You're just a bag holder in disguise, because you have zero DPI. How can you smile at me while you lie to me? Damn. Yo. Please leave my office. Thank you.
When did you stop feeling so sorry for yourself? It's unbearable. What? So you think we might have put a few people out of business today? That's all for naught. But you've been doing that every day for almost 40 years, Sam. And if this is all for naught, then so is everything out there. We just react. And we make a lot of money if we get it right. And there have always been and there always will be the same percentage of winners and losers, happy fox and sad sacks, fat cats and starving dogs in this world.
I'll do it, John, but not because of your little speech, but because I need the money. Hard to believe after all these years, but I need the money.
5, 6, 7, I just fired my best friend. That wasn't part of my plan. I just fired my best friend. That wasn't part of my plan. Now he's cold and broken, never wants to see my face again. Part of my plan. I just fired my that really change? I just made $1 million. What does that really change? It's not close enough to even buy a private plane or buy a yacht in St. Bart's to feel young.
Mental health conditions that entrepreneurs report are associated with personality traits that are really good to have if you're an entrepreneur. Creativity, extroversion, open-mindedness, risk propensity. And it turns out that some of these traits are associated with ADHD, bipolar spectrum conditions, depression, substance abuse. So their mental health symptoms can help them, and their mental health symptoms can trip them up.
Discover John C. Baxter, located inside his vehicle with an apparent gunshot wound to the head.
Sort of, can you give us any indication whether this was related to Enron's bankruptcy?
We do know that he was an Enron employee, but as far as any other indications of why he committed suicide, no, we do not.
You mentioned he was your best friend in your opening statement. Before he died, did you have many conversations with him?
Yes.
And were any of them relative to Enron?
Yes.
I think of it every day. I mean, I think of it all the time.
Do you believe that if Ian had not gone to work for Theranos, that he would be
here?
Oh,
yeah, for sure. No question.
One, two, three. could save me. Hold my hand once more. And if those